Hi, I'm Dave Larson at Intel, and today I'll explain several key factors that will help you get the best performance from platforms equipped with Intel Optane DC persistent memory. It is a revolutionary new class of server memory that offers DRAM-like performance with the capacity and data persistence of storage. It works with our new second generation Intel Xeon Scalable processor. DRAM memory and Optane persistent memory work together in the platform. Exactly how depends on which operating mode you select for the Optane persistent memory. In memory mode, all the data in memory is volatile, just like today, but you can take advantage of the affordable capacity of up to 3 terabytes per processor. In AppDirect mode, the application and OS are aware there are 2 different types of memory and can use them independently. If you want to use the persistent data features, you have to use AppDirect mode at an enabled operating system or applications. For software that uses AppDirect mode, it's best to consult with a vendor on the configuration they recommend for their application. Most of the rest of our talk will be about how to get the best performance in memory mode. There are 4 factors that we'll consider for best performance: correct DRAM ratio, slot configuration, processor core count, and workload behavior. In memory mode, the DRAM acts as a fast cache for the most frequently used data. You want a DRAM cache that's big enough so the requested data is in the cache most of the time. Intel recommends a ratio of 1 gigabyte of DRAM for every 8 gigabytes of Optane persistent memory. This should provide an adequate DRAM cache for most workloads when using memory mode. For example, if you have 1 terabyte of Optane persistent memory, you'll want to have 128 gigabytes of DRAM for an 8-to-1 ratio. The second factor is the memory slot configuration. Each second generation Intel Xeon scalable processor has 2 integrated memory controllers. Each controller has 3 memory channels, and each channel can support up to 2 memory slots. The configuration type is designated by the number of slots on each one of the memory controllers. Here is a 222 config where each controller has 2 slots on each of its 3 memory channels. That's a total of 12 slots per processor. A 221 configuration has 2 slots on 2 channels and 1 slot on the 3rd channel. That's 10 slots per processor. Here's a 211 configuration with 8 slots per processor. And finally, a 111 with 6 total slots. For best performance, you want to maximize the total memory bandwidth and the probability of a DRAM cache hit. To do this, place an Optane persistent memory module on the slot nearest the processor and a DRAM DIMM on the slot furthest from the processor. That means that a fast DRAM DIMM is available no matter which memory channel is accessed. Follow this rule on 222, 221, and 211 configurations. In the actual platform, the population looks like this. I've placed a DRAM DIMM in the appropriate slot of each channel, which are the blue slots. The Optane persistent memory modules go on the black slots on each channel. Keep in mind that the color will depend on your server manufacturer. You can spot the Optane modules by the silver clips in the integrated heat spreader. In a 111 configuration, you can only populate DRAM on 2 of the 3 channels for each memory controller. This limits the total bandwidth, so the 111 has the greatest risk of performance degradation. In AppDirect mode, this configuration may be fine since the application has full control over memory behavior and can compensate for the lower bandwidth. If the processor has more than 20 cores, use a configuration where you can place a DRAM on every channel. Those are the 222, 221, and 211 configurations. The 111 configuration should only be used with processors with 20 cores or fewer to make sure the cores aren't starved for memory services. The final factor is application behavior. The Intel Xeon processor uses a prediction algorithm to cache the most frequently used data in DRAM. If the application has moderate to high levels of predictability, the probability of successful caching increases. When that happens, the response latency is the same as DRAM. But if the data isn't in DRAM cache, the processor must fetch it from Optane persistent memory, which has a somewhat higher latency. If the application's data access pattern is highly random, you get more cache misses, and performance will be lower than if the system had been populated with only DRAM. Most applications are predictable enough that performance with Optane persistent memory is very close to an all DRAM configuration. But performance in a few benchmarks and applications can fall off noticeably. But those are situations that should be the minority. As with any new technology, you should test your applications to make sure that you'll meet your service level agreements. So that's it. You should enjoy great performance with Optane persistent memory with the proper configuration focused on these four factors. You'll get more affordable capacity and much faster performance in storing persistent data on SSDs or hard drives. For more information on Intel Optane DC persistent memory, please visit us at intel.com/optane and see the links provided.